If I was going to have a really healthy day, it would be about prioritizing the types of love. There are three universal categories of love or of motivation that drive people. And it might not seem intuitive to label them this way, but work with me for a minute. The fundamental categories are love of usefulness, love of the world, and love of the self. The way we interact with them and the way they're prioritized in us dictates everything. But to really believe that, you've got to meet them first. So yeah, I'm mowing the lawn, but check it. I'm using one of those no pollution reel mowers. So there it is, an action. But what's the essence of this action? What's the love that drives it? Which category is it? Well, that all depends on why I'm doing it. I might be doing it so that I look good. I want people to notice that I'm doing something good for the planet. I want to be part of a superior, eco-conscious, hip, cutting-edge group of people that are like so much more enlightened than the rest of the country and are the real heroes in the great struggle for blah, 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 blah. Everybody, meet love of the self. As the name implies, I have love of the self when I'd give anything for the cause of me. My number one priority is to benefit the self, whether it's about increasing its reputation, popularity, raising its official or unofficial status, power, influence. I'm the first and last thing on my mind, the apple of my own eye. But let's back up. It could be that I'm not mowing for those reasons at all. It might be that I'm here doing this, but I'm not really thinking about this green mower or this green grass, but something else that's green. Love of the world isn't just the love of money. At its essence, it's also the love of pleasure, if that makes sense. Things that are visually pleasing. Pleasing to the ear, pleasing to the palate, and all other kinds of intense, expensive, decadent stuff. When love of the world is in charge, that stuff is the goal, the highest good. Life is about creature comforts, about seeking out sensory experiences, of whatever kind floats your boat, or just hoarding cash. Maybe I have an eco-mo business, not because I care about the planet, but because I know that other people do, and I know I can exploit that to get some coin. If a better way to make more money came up, man, I'd ditch this so fast. So there it is, love of the world. Not so bad, but not so good either. Not really satisfied, living for future gratification. Meh. But don't we deserve a little bit more? I mean, can't this simple act, this little part of routine, really be something transcendent, something inspiring, a genuinely healthy action? Yeah, it can. And not because I'm having some mystical experience while I do it, not because I do it exceptionally fast or well, but because, put mundanely enough, I want to do this because it's good. Because of the good this does for the world. I'm not loving how it makes me look, I'm not loving what it gets for me, but I've kept a little bit of crud out of the atmosphere. And so here a little kid takes a breath of fresh air that's good for their lungs, and I'm loving that. People can sit in peace on their patio, and I'm loving that. Oil doesn't leak into the water supply so someone can drink and not carry toxins around with them, and I'm loving that. I'm loving the work and the health for my body so I can help others. I love the lawn space I'm creating for the kids and the dogs and the people that will play in it, the feelings they'll get out of it. I may not even meet some of these people, and they'll probably never draw the connection between these two events, but I know. I know the good this will do, and I'm holding that in my mind. The healthy kid, the clean water, the place to play. I know the function of this activity, its service to the common good, its use, and that's what it is to love usefulness. This is the sweet spot. That's high-quality fuel for a mind. Now, if you're like me, you're jumping around between these three types of motivation all the time, usually without even realizing it. It's not that these other two types are evil, and you've got to get rid of them and never talk to them again. Like I said before, it's all about priorities. We're all born with these three types of love inside us, but who's going to end up in charge? There are three basic vacancies in us. Let's call them the head, the body, and the feet. The head's in charge. It calls the shots. It sees and decides the course. The body responds and moves, and the feet just do what everyone tells them to. If love of the self takes the head, then I'm running for governor because I want to be governor. I want that title, I want that praise, I want that recognition. Getting kickbacks from lobbyists and the salary won't be that bad either. And as for the purpose of the position, the legislation, society at large, the problems people are having and how I can help, the suffering I can prevent, oh yeah, yeah, I mean it's good to do some of that stuff to get the people's affection. It's a good vehicle to get me where I want to go. But if love of the world is up top, then who cares how I look? This whole company exists to make me money. I'll fabricate profits to drive my stock up, I'll exploit loopholes, I'll cheat people out of their retirement money. Obviously, these two combinations don't work out well, for me or for the rest of the world. But if these three forces end up in the order they were meant to be in, the order that makes us healthy and human, then I'm doing my job in integrity for the good of the world, or I'm making my little donation to Habitat for Humanity because I'm thinking about what it feels like to have somewhere to live, the joy of having a clean, safe space for the most important things in your life. The tax break is cool, but it's not a deal breaker if it doesn't work out. If nobody notices, okay. If someone does, well, who doesn't like to be appreciated? And under the umbrella of loving usefulness, the other two can be in tune, laid back. I'm not trying to lecture you about it. I'm not just trying to say, don't be bad, be good. Everyone knows that already. But for me, being aware of the categories and cognizant of which one I'm operating from is like being given the way out of a maze. If I'm mowing for the first two reasons, yeah, what's growing in the yard ends up the same, but what's growing in me, it's night and day. Watch the way anxiety and tension follow these first two. I would never realize, oh, it's not about figuring out the minutiae of trying to be seen as exactly the person I want to be seen as, or being surrounded with just the things I want to be surrounded by, which always seems like I'm getting close, but never quite satisfied. This shows me, dude, it's a trap. You're on the whole wrong freeway. Universal categories of love. I'm just trying to pass them along for you if you want them, and just trying to order them correctly in myself whenever I can. Like, just as an example, let's say I was making a video about the universal categories of love. Would I just do it to make myself look good? Okay, so what I want you to do is just like make me look really cool.
That's impossible.
Well then just like make everything else look bad so that I look really good. Or do I do it with love of the world on top? Okay, so it says here that people are more likely to donate if just put in some violin music and like a please donate button. Or am I doing it for the sake of the information, to get helpful things out? Simply because you and I are probably going through some of the same struggles, and maybe with the right tools we can make some progress. And if I did make a video like that, would I try to make it look like I thought it all up myself? Or would I mention Swedenborg and his essay on the three universal categories of love? Oh, I don't know. This is getting a little too hypothetical, don't you think?